Dear viewers, welcome back to my channel. I was going to be away for 2 weeks and that turned into 5 weeks. It has been absolutely necessary for me. I struggle with a chronic illness, rheumatoid arthritis that flares up every now and then and becomes quite disabling. I also have my own mental health hardships, and so it has been essential for me to just slow down and focus on my life on the farm. This winter has been an unusually mild winter for us, probably the mildest winter I have ever experienced in Ontario. Normally, Februarys are frigid with minus 20 degrees Celsius or lower temperatures. We didn't really have that this year. That did mean that we got to spend more time outside and enjoy the snow and just a lot more time being able to enjoy the great outdoors. My biggest update to share with you is that our mother hen Yo-Yo has hatched 6 baby chicks. They are so cute and we are absolutely overjoyed. 6 chicks hatched beautifully and they are just so precious. They have been growing quickly, they're growing feathers and flying around. You can tell that Yo-Yo is so happy to be a mother. As you can see, the babies love to jump on Mother Yo-Yo. They find it just so adorable, they're so playful and happy little chicks, and I love just watching them, sometimes for hours. My sincere wish is that all of you have been able to slow down as well, especially for those of you who are experiencing winter like me. This is the best time, the most important time, to just take your time. It's okay. Things that can wait can wait. Your body comes first. Listen to your body and its needs and rest as much as you can. To support my mental and emotional health this past month, I've really relied on a wonderful new mindfulness and sleep app called Aura Health. Aura Health includes thousands of meditations, soundscapes, breathwork, stories, coaching, ASMR, and more. It features hundreds of therapists, coaches, guides from all around the world to guide you through difficult emotions and help you with different therapeutic techniques. Lately, I've been struggling with anxiety in the morning and throughout the day, a feeling of restlessness and fight or flight mode. I just can't seem to relax. So I have been relying on Aura Health to help me get through the day. I have been choosing grounding and calming meditations to help relax my nervous system, bring me back into my body, and just feel a sense of peace again. I've tried a lot of mindfulness and sleep apps in the past, and Aura Health has worked the best for me because it really personalizes the content in my feed based on what I enjoy listening to and what I have been struggling with. It's really helpful to just open up the app and I can find what I need right away in the moment. Aura Health has been so helpful during this difficult period in my life for restoring a sense of balance and peace in me. Get started today for completely free using the link right here and in my description box and pinned comment. The first 500 people get a free trial plus an exclusive 25% off the subscription. By using my link, you are helping to support my channel so that I can continue to make videos like these for you. Thank you so much, and I hope you enjoy today's video featuring my beautiful cousin Ediya. Welcome, John and Ediya. Thanks for having me. Yes, such a pleasure. Today I'm very excited about this video. I'm going to be giving Ediya a little makeover, make her look like a... Well, she's already very beautiful, but even more beautiful Kazakh princess kind of style. And as you can see, she's wearing this blue embroidered mishpit, just like a vest from the traditional Kazakh culture. So Ediya's background heritage is Kazakh mostly. Her mom is Kazakh and her dad is half Kazakh. And my dad is Ediya's dad's brother, so that's where I get my Kazakh too. But I'm not as connected to that part of my heritage as she is. So it's really nice getting to learn some from her and from her parents. So today we really want to honor our heritage, our ancestry, and just have some fun and, you know, enjoy some relaxing hair play and styling and choosing a selection of beautiful traditional Kazakh jewelry that I've set aside on the right here. I have some earrings, some fancy dangling necklaces, statement necklaces, lots of bracelets and rings as well. So we will adorn Ediya with all of this beautiful jewelry. And we will choose a hat, much like the one that I'm wearing. I'll show you. This is the hat I'm wearing. And it's called, what did you say it was called?
Selkilik.
And it's so colorful with all these little beads that are adorning it and these owl feathers. And it matches the mishpit that I'm wearing. It's also really colorful, hand embroidered. So, such a treat to get to wear these beautiful pieces. Okay, so I want to start with just combing out your hair, Ediya. And just detangling it. The hairstyle that Ediya chose for today is two thinner braids in the front and two thicker braids in the back, which is quite common in among Kazakh women and girls to have two thick braids and sometimes some cute little braids in the front or other parts as well. And you know, it's common to put jewelry and feathers and little dangling coins on chains in the hair, and a headpiece necklaces, all of those. So yes, feeling very inspired. Ediya is planning on making a visit to Kazakhstan this year sometime to explore her culture more and hopefully also find some really wonderful treasures and jewelry that she can incorporate into her wardrobe.
I'm really wanting to find a headdress. That's currently what's missing in the collection that my mom and I have been curating.
Yeah. It looks so beautiful on you. Maybe you could even wear them in your videos.
Yeah, totally.
So, I want to start by parting your hair right in the middle. Kazakh girls often do a middle part. That's what we're doing today. As best as we can. So find that middle part right there. That's a good. To section off the front two little braids. Let me come to the side here and grab maybe just that much. Let's see here. Just come to the side here and see what looks good. So now that I've sectioned this side, I'm going to clip this hair back. Perfect. Make sure it's symmetrical on both sides, like this. No, more like that. Let's see what I did here. Yes. Compare the two. I mean, it doesn't have to be perfect, but I like to make sure the end result is as know, as pleasing to the eye as possible. Yes, I like that. Secure it with an elastic band for now, and then I think I will incorporate it into the larger braid. It just makes sense to do it that way. So I wanted to try more of a French braid on this side. I'll leave some of your baby hairs down. It looks really cute. So we'll do sort of like that kind of look. So just section the hair back. It might look really cute. Okay, let's do that. Smaller sections of hair, just like this. Perfect. sort of braiding it to the side so that we can easily incorporate it into the larger braid. Adding little bits of hair as I go. Making sure it looks well organized. It's very important. Find that when I braid, I have to really focus on every little strand. Not every little strand, but as much as possible, keep maintaining focus so that I don't miss any strands. Applying a little bit of organic argan and olive oil. I find that your hair loves to come out of the braid since you have very straight hair. Alright, Ediya, I'd like for you to choose a few little trinkets to add to your braid. These are the ones that we have. Choose how many and what kind.
Two of these.
Sure. this one at the bottom and then these higher up kind of thing?
Yeah.
Okay. Can do that for sure. Actually, oops. Might look a bit better to use this one on the bottom since this part's kind of thicker. Might be perfect for these areas where a little bangs are coming out. Just secure it. This little trinket. Now it's looking really pretty. And did you want one higher up or lower? For this one. Cairo, maybe.
Like yeah. That. Okay. Cairo.
Wow. Wow. It's so much fun. Okay. Did you want to do the same thing on the other side?
Yeah.
Making sure to leave some baby hairs down. I want to make sure it's as symmetrical as I can. I like that. Tiny little strands. Tiny, tiny little strands in the front, weaving them in. Getting sleepy. As I'm braiding, I'm just looking over to the other side to make sure, mostly following the same kind of pattern. The last bit of hair I'll weave in to this braid. Right there. Great. Okay. accumulate down. The braid gets thinner. Go as far as I can while there's still hair to be braided. Okay. It's probably as far as I can go. Securing it with an elastic band. Get it on the same level, right about there. About there. Good. Now that these intricate little parts are done, we're going to go ahead and do the main braid.
Okay. Oh, it's so pretty.
You like it?
Yeah.
I just had Ediya Janem turn around and I'm going to go ahead and braid the back. Let's continue that middle part. I love these patterns back here, the mishpit. So pretty. Little waves. Perfect. I'm going to apply a little bit more oil. So much easier to braid with a good amount of hair oil. It smells really nice too. This part, I am just finding three sections. And the third one is actually going to be this braid that I already did. Another section of the area. Thank you.
making sure that it's adequately tight so that it doesn't loosen up on its own. Is that okay, tightness-wise? Okay.
Yeah. It could be tighter.
Tighter? I'm gonna finish the other side and then add the little pieces into it.
All right, Ediya, so now that the braids are all done, I'd like to add some more sparkly things in your hair. So you just go ahead and let me know which of these you'd like me to add in.
So I think we can add a couple of these. I was also thinking perhaps we can kind of hook the earrings onto trinkets. So let's
book this.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
So this one.
Thank you. I want to add the little earrings in the front. Apply this one here. I'm just kind of putting them all over just because I think it's so cute. Oh, wow. So all the parts where I'm noticing like some of your layered hair coming out, I'm just clipping it with these trinkets so it just stays in place better. Wow. That's so pretty. Okay, so now that we have all these beautiful little trinkets in your hair, let's choose some jewelry for you. Here are our options.
I'm really drawn to the red. Let's start.
What length you like? That length or shorter?
No, I think this is perfect.
Okay.
And
for the earrings.
Maybe we can go with this to match the earrings on my hair. Or wait. This would match the necklace more. Let's go with this.
Take these off. Some bracelets.
Yeah. On this one.
On which hand?
On my right hand. Oh, so pretty.
Any others? which finger? Perfect fit.
What do you think? Are we done?
It's up to you. Perfect. Okay. I love it. And now we're gonna choose one of the hats. So I've got this one back here. I love this. Make sure the earrings still poke out a bit. Oh, I love that. What do you think?
My head's a little big, so I can kind of feel it. Not entirely.
Do you want me to pin it in? Mm-hmm. Got some bobby pins.
That's okay.
Okay.
So I want to be able to take it off whenever I want.
Okay. We can also try some other options. What do you think? A little small.
Yeah.
But that one also looks really nice.
Yeah.
But the gold doesn't quite match the rest of your jewelry and stuff. So, but it is beautiful. I love the feathers.
Yes.
Here's another option. What do you think of this one?
Yeah, this is nice too.
Let's try it.
The way it matches what I'm wearing.
Ooh, that fits better too.
This fits. Mm-hmm. But the blue is not exactly the same.
You're right.
Shade. Yeah.
Hmm. Does look very nice though. That I was wearing earlier. The owl feathers. It's beautiful, but the gold doesn't quite match either.
Yeah.
What's your favorite one?
I think I like what we started with.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's do that one. Like you're ready for a wedding, or would you wear even more for a wedding?
Yeah, no, I don't think this is grand enough for a wedding.
Grand enough.
I'm ready for an outing.
An outing, yeah.
Or to visit the neighbors. I should like the outfit without the hat.
Yeah. Oh, okay, you want to take the hat off?
Yeah. I
Hey everyone, I hope you enjoyed this wonderful Kazakh makeover for beautiful. How do you say beautiful in Kazakh?
Sulu.
Sulu?
Yeah, Sulu.
Sulu?
Yeah.
Sulu Ediya, Janum Ediya. And then I learned another word, Arailum. Arailum, which means like sunshine. And that was a lot of fun for me. I felt like back when we were young, you know, so many years ago at this point. Thank you so much for that.
Thank you. Yeah. You're so beautiful.
Yeah, you are. Okay. Everyone watching, have a great night, and I hope you have some really sweet dreams.